parents, educators, grandparents, and child caregivers. Welcome to Intellakids. This is Aishan. One important part of teaching young children about math is helping them to understand the concepts of less than, more than, or equal to. Learning to compare quantities helps preschoolers begin to make sense of the relationship between numbers, such as if one number is bigger, smaller, or equal to another number. Like 5 is 1 less than 6, but it is 1 more than 4. As my audience is all adults and already advanced simple math, we forget how difficult it was when we first started learning these early math skills. We wouldn't be able to do complex addition or subtraction problems if we didn't know what number is greater or which number is less. Therefore, these concepts are key in the beginning to understand addition and subtraction. Please watch me showing you an activity about how I teach this concept to young children. Okay, to do this lesson, I'm gonna need a piece of paper. It doesn't have to be colored, but I like to use this red color today. And I'm going to use scissors and some Lego pieces. It's a very simple but very fun activity, trust me. So first, I'm going to make less than, greater than, and equal signs. I have my less than, greater than, and equal to signs. I actually always like to write the name of the symbols so my student can actually see the written version of that word. So I'm going to write less than, greater than, and equal to on my signs. So let's do it. This will be greater than. This is less than. And this is equal to. Alright, the next part of my game that I'm gonna use some Legos. Legos are very good tools to show the kids the quantity of something since they're all each individual pieces. So watch me how I use Legos on my lesson. So I have these Legos in front of me and I'm going to put the Legos in two groups and ask my student to pick the bigger one, smaller one, or if they're the same, the student should be able to tell me that they're the same. Let's see. All right, as you can see, I put 5 on one side and 4 on the other side. Now, my student is going to use these signs and tell me which one is less, which one is more. So I would expect my student, my very young student, to count each Legos with the finger. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if my child is able to tell me which one is greater, it's perfect, then I will ask my child to pick the sign. I know 4 is less than 5. Let's say my student doesn't get it, doesn't know the answer, or still haven't figured out this concept. It's perfectly fine. That's why I chose Legos. So now I'm gonna ask my student to put all the Legos on top of each other and tell me which one is longer. Let's do it. Okay, I have have 5 Legos here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we're going to do the other group. This is also can be a lesson for measurement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, I will ask my student to put two of them next to each other and tell me which one is longer. Now, my student has a much better idea because he can see with his eyes in reality that 5 is bigger than 4, because when you put 5 Legos on top of each other, it's taller than 4 Legos on top of each other. So that gives him the understanding of concept of comparing quantity. Now, after my student says which one is taller, then I tell my student, okay, the taller, the bigger, the greater. Now, can you use the sign and show me the greater one? And student is gonna get the greater sign and show me the greater one. And let's do another one like this. I have another group of Legos in front of me, and I'm going to ask my student to count each group and tell me how many Legos in each group there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 and 6. And if my student knows they're equal numbers, he or she already developed the understanding of the same numbers are the equal. That's fine. So I will ask him to bring the sign, and she or he will probably bring the equal sign. That's perfect. But again, just because we're working with Legos, if my student is lacking of the understanding and 6 is equal to 6, I'm going to ask my student to put all the Legos together and compare the Legos. After my student put these Legos together, I'm going to bring the Legos right next to each other and ask my student, are they equal, or one of them are taller, or one of them is shorter? This is the point where the student will exactly know these two are actually the same and their length is the same. Now I'm going to ask my student to bring the sign in between. So this is the equal sign, where my student gets to know the signs but also understanding the concept of comparing things. Parents and educators, you just watched me showing a lesson to my young students about comparing numbers. Please don't forget, this is also an activity where you can do anywhere and anytime. Here's a wonderful on-the-go car activity. Tell your child that you're thinking of a number between 1 and 10. As your child makes guesses, indicate whether each guess is less than or more than the correct answer. Encourage your child to find the answer in 3 guesses. Then trade the places. Have your child think of a number between 1 and 10 and have everyone else make guesses. Have your child say whether each guess is less than or more than what he was thinking. We're at the end of another Intellakids video. Thank you so much for watching us. Intellakids is wishing you a happier and greater day ahead.